This tutorial will show you how to combine the automatic transition with painted Bezier curves. It will look like this. What is happening here is there is an automatic transition between these four images and a separate transition of painted Bezier paths on top. First, I'll just erase the paint action sequence so we can start fresh. When I create the transition context in the paint action sequence, I am going to use multiple keys this time. This way, I can select several images or videos at once and then time expand them automatically. I will do this using action, paint action sequence timeline, record context, multiple keys from disk, and then choose transition. All of the images used here are in your Studio Artist folder. Now that I have my keyframes, I will expand them by using action, paint action sequence timeline, then time compress expand. This number is using times by. So since there is no space between my frames, I'm going to input 20, which will give me 20 keyframes between my images. This also added a lot of keyframes past my last image, so I'm going to change the number of keyframes to 61 here. Now that I expanded to 20 keyframes, if I wanted to have, say, 40, I would just add 2 here and it would double the keyframes. For this demonstration, we really only need 20. So now if I click on the red keyframes, we can see the four images. Because I want to add some effects that will be using the canvas as well as the source, I am going to add a step that adds the source to the canvas. I will do that by choosing the erase icon and adding the source image to the canvas. Make sure that record is checked in the paint action sequence window. Then in the transition context, in the paint action sequence editor, I am going to change the transition destination to source. I also want to point out that this is also set to the flow transition algorithm. This way, the source will have the transition images, and at the same time they will also show up in the canvas. If I click at frame 15, you can see the transition images in both the canvas and the source. Next, I will add some interest to these images with an image operation effect and record that into the paint action sequence. Next, I am going to add the Bezier paths that I will be painting in with the paint synthesizer. First, I am going to delete any paths that may be in the Bezier mode by choosing Path, Path Layer commands, and Erase. Next, I'm going to generate automatic Bezier paths using a preset and image operations. I'm going to choose this line sketch preset in sketch styles. Then to create the Bezier paths, I will choose path, generate paths, and choose image operations. You can also generate paths by choosing vectorizer presets. To see the paths, I need to toggle to the Bezier edit mode. Now we can see the paths. I'm going to erase the canvas to white so we can just see the paths. I'm also going to record this step erasing the canvas to white, and I'm going to place it at the top of the list. I like to do this with most paint action sequences to clear the canvas as a housekeeping step. I am also going to mute it after the first keyframe by Option M, clicking for Mac, or Alt M, clicking for Windows on keyframe 2. This way the canvas will clear to white only one time. Next, I am going to arrange and thin out the Bezier paths and record the changes in the paint action sequence. I am going to do this through Path, Path Layer commands. First, I am going to connect the curves if they are close. Next, I'm going to size prune. There are several other types of arranging or styling you can do with the paths. For instance, simplify will look like this. Now that I have the Bezier paths the way I want them, I am going to record the transitions by choosing Path, then convert to paint synthesizer, then convert paint action sequence context keyframes to Bezier context. And that will result in the Bezier paths for each image as well as the transitions between them. As you can see, it runs through the paint action sequence 4 times because there are 4 images. Here is the result. If I click through the timeline on this last step, you can see the results of the transitioning Bezier paths. I am now going to do 2 more steps to optimize the flow of the Bezier paths. I will choose Action, Paint Action Sequence Timeline, Embedded Bezier Frame, and then Normalize Recycle. Normalize Split and Normalize Recycle ensure that each image in the timeline has the exact same number of Bezier paths as the next image. If the number of paths don't match between two keyframes, Normalize Recycle will duplicate paths so that both will match. Normalize Split, on the other hand, will split paths so that both will match. Next, I will also reorder minimal distance using the slow algorithm. If you have a lot of images, this could take time, so you also have the option of the fast algorithm. You can see the progress at the bottom right of the interface. Now I'm going to mute these previous Bezier steps because all of these steps are now recorded in the Bezier context step. Now that I have created and modified the Bezier paths, I am now going to paint them using a preset from the paint synthesizer. I'm going to choose a sketch preset called Outline Simple Color Palette from the Sketch Outline category. I'm going to click Action so you can see the preset. I'm just going to undo this because I need to make a few changes in the editor. In pen mode, if a preset is set to autodraw interactive, it will generally not work well with painting Bezier paths, especially for this purpose, and sometimes, depending on other settings, it may not paint at all. Let me demonstrate. To paint Bezier paths with a paint preset, you need to choose Path, Paint Paths, Full Layer, or you can use Command-K for Mac or Control-K for Windows. So as you can see, nothing was painted. But when I change the pen mode to interactive pen and paint the paths again, they now appear in the canvas. This preset is vector, but I want to change the vector stroke type to Bezier path. So I'll toggle to the vector output panel. This will allow the option to paint the path with dots. So I will now repaint the Bezier paths with these new settings by choosing Command-K. If you are on Windows, you would use Control-K. I want these dots to be larger, so I will toggle to Brush Source and make the path wider. First, I will undo this by choosing Edit, Undo Paint Paths Full Layer. Then I will try again by choosing the shortcut Command-K for Mac or Control-K for Windows to paint the paths. That's good, so now I will save these changes into this step. I accidentally recorded an extra step, so I will just delete it. Now I will option click for Mac or alt click for Windows on the outline paint step to record the changes. I'm going to add a few more effects. First, I'm going to add some more outline and then bring in a little of the source image. Now I will click on the number 1 above the first keyframe and click play to see the final effects. That's good, so I will now output it to a movie by choosing Action, Animate with a Paint Action Sequence, to Movie. And again, here is the auto flow transitions with the added Bezier paths transitions.